Well, that's not enough to worry about. I told people that, you know, on your side, that this is just pack on.
Besides, your strength is in shear.
That's what I tell people, do not weld to the tank or the bolt. Don't touch that, you know, right, that part of it. It will put a strain on it. But if you just tack weld the one flat on it, that's all I want to do, is tack weld the one flat of the six. Not like the real, enough that you just think the bolt is turning a little bit.
That's right.
Because that way, if somebody says it needs to be a certified site, well, I'm just going to say you tack weld the head, right? So we're not putting our instructions to tack weld the head to it. If they don't want to do that.
So we'll lift, and then Fred, can you pull that wood out?
Yeah. Get my fingers under there.
Ah, wait. Okay, second verse, same as the first.
I was just running. I was just running. I was just running.
And here, we're dang near there. We could,
oh, you're right. You're pretty much right on it, actually.
Well, but
a little farther away.
The hammer, Mike?
I got it. Order you. 67. 3/4 plus a little.
Yeah, everybody.
Okay, so that's good.
That's true. Cracks underneath the ground.
Okay, now let's do that again. It's close enough. Let's work on elevations and then do the fine tuning. Pack of wood shims.
Better than the truck box.
Up a little. Up a little more. I like it. Maybe a shim right there. We need the bucket of sweeps, a speed bore, and some electrical tape.
You know, it's like a paddle bit for drilling wood.
Oh, ever. You see the Milky Way, just the same line, and it's just going, wow.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Passed. Okay.
Okay.
Huh? Looking good.
Thank you.
I've been told